All right, we stopped the previous episode here, and I told you I want to create an animation of this camera. I want to make something like this. Rotating the camera, exploding components, putting them back together, rotating them again, and try to make the lens work. So let's begin. Once you have all your mates in place, you can save your component. And we want to go to the assembly tab and click on exploded view. Exploded view does not break your mates. It just creates a view that your components are apart from each other. The best way to do it is to start to dismantle your component from the last component that you assigned. So if you're putting them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 together, you dismantle it 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So in this case, I want to select the first component, drag it a little bit out, drag it a little bit further here, and click on done. We don't want to go into details of exploded view because there are other ways, there are automated ways. I don't want to do that. We select the next component, select it, bring it out, and this time we go up and done. We select the third component, the ring. We bring it out, done. This one, done. Again, sorry, this one, up. So further up, done. This one, here, done. Select it again, and this time, back, and cut. So this is how my camera looks like, and I haven't broken any mates. All the mates are effective in place, but it looks like this. To bring it back to its collapse mode, I will go to the design tree here, select on my assembly, right click, and click on collapse. Everything jumps back to where they were, and they are still functional. And here is what's interesting. I can right click on it. Instead of explode, which brings it to this way, or collapse, which brings them back together, I can click on animate explode or animate collapse. As you can see, look. So we want to have this explosion view in place before we can go and create the animation. So let me just collapse them together and click on motion study tab down here. Look, motion study, which gives me a timeline with the units of seconds. There are some tools here that I can assign to this assembly, like engine, spring, contact, gravity, so on and so forth. And there is a magic tool, animation wizard, which helps me to create some animation. Click on that first. I'll just start easy. I have three options: initially, rotate, explode, and collapse. If you don't have your exploded view, these two options wouldn't appear for you. So I want to rotate it first. Let's say along the z-axis. I want to rotate it one time clockwise and for the duration of 5 seconds. Then I click on finish, and it creates this video for me. So if I click on play, maybe I should have rotated it around a different angle. Wow, that's too long. At this point, I want to zoom in a little bit. Okay, when I zoom in, you see there is a symbol appears next to my mouse, which looks like a forbidden or prohibited because the movement is disabled. This is what we have so far. Okay, one rotation, then it stops. I want to click on the animation wizard again, click on explode, next. Duration for 5, a starting point. We are already at 5, so yeah, 5 is fine. Let's start at 5. So this is that. And one more time, collapse. Duration 5, starting point 10, because I want the collapse to be started when the explode is finished. And play from the beginning. So we have the rotation, which sucks. I'm gonna delete it later. We have the explosion. And then we have the collapse. And that's that. All right. Now I want to zoom in a little bit. Okay. The way to do it is to first bring the timeline where you want your video, the zooming, to be finished. So we stop at 15 time mark, and I want to go for another 2 seconds zooming in. The way to do it is to right click on this orientation and camera view here and enable view key creation. Now if I zoom in, see, it changed, but it changed in a way that I don't want to. I will show you how the results look like. After this keyframe here, it starts to zoom in, if I'm not mistaken. See, yeah, it's zooming in while it is exploding and while it's collapsing. But I wanted the explode and collapse to happen, then I start to zoom. So first Control Z back, and the issue was that this is the last key on the orientation. Look, this is the orientation and this is the timeline in front of it. Everything you see here, every component is listed here. This is our y-axis and this is our x-axis. X are the seconds, y are what. Okay, I want the zooming to start from the 15 seconds time mark and go all the way to 17. So for that, I right click somewhere around here and click place a key. And now if I zoom in, this zooming in starts from the last key that I selected. Look, this time it works good. So we have a rotation, we have the exploded view, we have collapsing, and we have the zooming. My name is Arjan, and this is what I do, baby. Let me just disable the view, because if you do not disable the view and you want to go ahead and take a look at your component, every movement you do is being recorded. So if you're not going to record that movement, just disable it again, okay? Otherwise, everything I do here will be recorded and will be played back to you. We don't want this. Okay, I wanted to tell you that why I cannot make a video of this happening. Because two of the mates that we used, namely Slot and Pathmate, cannot be used in the animation, unfortunately. This is not a good thing. But one thing else we can do is this. Certainly we can do this. Wait. I wanna zoom in a little bit and then manually bring this component out, and people will think it actually worked. Okay, so go back in, please go back in. Right. So from this point, orientation available, I want to rotate it like this. If I play it from this point, how does it look? Yep. And then we zoom in. Now I can disable that. And what are the components that I want to use? One of them is this one. So I want to add a keyframe here. And the other one is this. Lens gear. No, I'm sorry. Zoom ring, yeah. So I want to add a keyframe here. Right click, place a key. Control C, Control V. Doesn't work. Now let's try it anyway. Bring the timestamp to 32. Then move this part out. Let's see how the video looks like from this point. You have a smooth transition, then this lens comes out. Let's just calculate everything from 0.0. Right. Now it worked. And just making sure that, yeah, view key creation is disabled. Let's just do some manual rotation at the end. I would like to do so. Probably need to have a key here. Right, and then activate it. Zoom it. Let's see how it looks like. I press F to bring it at the end. Right. So this is the animation and we want to save it. All you have to do is click on save animation and you can save it as an AVI or other formats. We'll just save it as MP4. I just put it here. And image size ratio, that's fine. And click OK. Yeah, render it. So re-rendering the movements. Now I want to stop. Okay, let's see if the video is okay. So this is the animation. This was a very fast intro for beginners into assembly. Don't forget, there are other stuff you need to learn. How to do duplicate a component, how to make two components together really fast, like what I'm doing, and then how to create multiple components. Like if you wanna pattern something, you still have the pattern tool here, and you could create multiple components. You don't have to enter them one by one. Look, right click, okay. Of this component, I can create four of them immediately here. There are different tools that I haven't covered, and it will make your job a little bit more difficult when you're starting because it gets overwhelming. So I left all of that on my website and not in these mini series because it takes really long. And already I have been speaking for 1.5 hours now. It doesn't look that way to you because there are some edits to remove the puffs. I drink a sip of water. So you think it's only 20 minutes, but it takes 3 times that much. And on top of that, the editing and so on. If I want to make a 20 hours video, I have to spend much, much longer. And I have done so on my website. So feel free to go and check it out. I hope you like the video. Let me know what you think of it. I apologize if the pace was too fast or too slow because I cannot make a video that appeals to every taste. Some people like to move faster. Some people like take things slower. So I hope I did something for everyone. Don't forget to like the video if it helped you and recommend it to a friend. All the comments will be answered. I read every single comment. Don't forget to go check out the webinar. Subscribing is also appreciated. It's kind of a reward for me. Thank you.